And now we will learn all about tracking mileage, also called vehicle usage per job. Mileage slips are not transactions. They are documents of events that will affect future transactions. They have their own separate set of reports. They behave exactly the way time slips do. This means you have to choose a service item if you mark the mileage as billable to a client. To set up and prepare QuickBooks to be able to bill clients for mileage, we have to make a service item for miles driven. We have to choose or make an income account to track the income from billable vehicle mileage. We will make an account called Income from Billed Mileage. We will also make a service item on the items list called Billable Miles Driven. And since we're advanced in QuickBooks, we can make both of these at the same time. From the main menu, click List, Item List. In the bottom left of the item list, click Item, New. Now this goes on the list as a service, and it's billable miles driven. Okay, we leave the rate blank, and then in the account field, we see that there is no account called Income from Billed Miles, so we have to make one. Click here, scroll up, and click Add New. Notice QuickBooks knows this is an income account, and we type the name Income from Billed Miles. Okay, then save and close. Now we have everything we need for the new item. Click OK, and now our item is on the items list waiting to be used when we bill clients for mileage. The second part of the setup involves putting the vehicle's names and descriptions on the vehicle list. In our example, we have Vehicle 1, Toyota Corolla, 2015, donated by the owner on June 20th of 2015. From the main menu, click Lists, Customer and Vendor Profile List, and go down to the bottom where it says Vehicle List. Now, in the bottom left of the Vehicle List window, click Vehicle, New. The name of it in this case will be Toyota-Car, because it's not a minivan, and you can put anything in the description you like. We will put donated on June 20 of 2015. And you can put whatever other information you think is helpful to identify the particular vehicle that you're using. When we click OK, we see it's added to the vehicle list. And the next vehicle we will add is a Ford minivan donated by the owner on July 20 of 2016. Again, in the bottom left of the vehicle list, click Vehicle, New, and the name of it will be Ford Minivan, donated July 20 of 2016. You could put the beginning mileage or the mileage at the moment it was donated or any other relevant information you think is necessary right here in the description. Click OK and you have finished the second part of the setup, adding the vehicles to the vehicle list. And of course, the last part of the setup is putting up the mileage related reports. For mileage tracking, the two best reports are the mileage by vehicle summary and the mileage by job detail, where there's also a summary and a detail, but we will work with the detail. From the main menu, click Reports, Jobs, Time, and Mileage, Mileage by Vehicle Summary. make sure in the top left you push A for all, and then when this is the active window, click View, add mileage by vehicle summary to the icon bar, and click OK. Now we'll do the other report. Reports, jobs, time, and mileage, mileage by job detail. And of course, the pull-down menu in the top left should say A for all. And then we have to modify this so that we could add the notes. Remember, because this is not a transaction, you have to record as much detail as possible for each event. In the top left, click Customize Report, and then make sure the Display tab is showing in the Modify Report Mileage by Job Detail window. Scroll down to where it says Notes and click in the left margin. Then click OK and you see a column has been added for notes. You should click to the right of the word notes on the three dots to get the double arrow. Click and drag to make it wider so that you can see as much of the notes as possible in the report. Believe me, this is going to be helpful to you. Now that it looks the way we need it to look, click View, add mileage by job detail to the icon bar, and click OK. Notice, if you run out of room in the icon bar, QuickBooks gives you a double arrow with the pull-down menu where you can click for the extra icons that don't fit in the icon bar. And now we're ready to record our first set of mileage. Let's imagine on April 19th, we drove the Toyota car for the Hanson Place job, and the starting mileage was 17,610, and the ending mileage was 17,920, and it does not say that this is billable to the job. Let's take a look at how to record it. From the main menu, click Company, enter vehicle mileage. The vehicle was the Toyota car. The date was April 19th of 2017. The trip ended on the same day, April 19th of 2017. But of course, if it ended on different days, you would put the beginning date and the ending date. Now, the odometer start and the instructions say 17,610. No problem. 17,610. Push the tab key to save it. The odometer finish was 17,920. So, 17,920. Push tab and you see QuickBooks tells you the difference in mileage. The job in this case was the Hanson Place job, but we will not put an item because this particular vehicle mileage is not billable. We just want to know where the miles went, which job, even though we're not going to bill it. And the notes are very important. You can type anything you think is helpful. Wow, this was a long trip, or whatever else you'd like to put. After you click Save and Close, you can open up Mileage by Vehicle Summary and see that the total miles so far for just this one vehicle is 310 miles. If you open the other report, Mileage by Job Detail, you can see the notes, you can see all the details about that particular entry and that particular trip that was entered as mileage for April 19th. And by the way, if you double-click right here on this line, you will go back to the original entry of the vehicle miles entered, and you can change anything you want. And now, let's see one that's billable. Let's imagine on April 21, we drove the Ford van for the Southwoods Road job, and the starting mileage was 4,990, and the ending mileage was 5,220. Again, from the main menu, click Company, enter Vehicle Mileage. The vehicle in this case was the Ford minivan. The start date of the trip was April 21, and the end date of the trip was also, April 21, and the end date of the trip was also April 21. The odometer start was 49.90, and the odometer end was 52.20. QuickBooks calculates 230 miles. Now, the job was the Southwoods Road job, and in this case, it is billable. So because it's billable, you should click the item and choose billable miles driven. Then you should put in the notes whatever you think is helpful. Kirschbaum was happy that we took the van, or whatever else you need to type that was helpful information for you. When we click Save and Close, we can ignore all the spelling suggestions, and then we can open up the Mileage by Vehicle Summary, and you can see the Ford minivan had 230 miles, and the Toyota car had 310 miles. You may well ask, what is this mileage expense? And I do promise at the end of the video, I will be explaining what mileage expense means. In the meantime, let's take a look at the other report, Mileage by Job Detail, and you will see all the information about this particular trip is written here across this line. It's under the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job, and you could see how many miles it is and the date and if it's billable or not. And now the conclusion of our little story happens when we finally bill Kirschbaum for the miles. Let's imagine on April 23, we billed Kirschbaum for the April 21 work that required driving there in the minivan, and we charged Kirschbaum $5 per mile. From the icon bar, we open the invoice window. We choose the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum. Now, we do have an available estimate where we can take the information and put it on an invoice with these miles. But to keep things simple, we won't use the estimate. We'll just use the billable cost or the billable miles. When we click OK, you can see in the Choose Billable Time and Cost window that the only thing available to bill is one event of mileage. And this is the one we just entered. To select it, we click the check mark in the margin and then click OK. Notice it has all of the miles driven, and all we have to do is put the price per mile that we're charging Kirschbaum, and on the left of your keyboard push tab. Now this invoice is asking him to pay $1,150 for all of the miles that we had to drive to be able to service him. After we click Save and Close, of course, we're going to ignore this tricky default. Save and close, ignore all the spelling, and ignore the credits that are available for now. Now that we've finally saved that invoice, we can open up the profit and loss by job. And you can see for the Southwoods Road Kirschbaum job, we now have income from billed miles, $1,150. Now, of course, many of you are asking, what does it mean mileage expense, and how did that get there on this mileage by vehicle summary? Well, it's very interesting. You see, the IRS allows you to take a certain amount of deduction from your taxes for miles driven that relate to business. The money amount that you see on the report means nothing. It is not a transaction, it is not affecting your chart of accounts, your general ledger, and it has not been added or subtracted to any area of QuickBooks. All it is a suggestion for the amount that QuickBooks believes that you are allowed to deduct from your taxes for miles driven by vehicles that relate to business. For more information about the mileage expense and how it affects your QuickBooks records and how it affects your taxes, please discuss the issue with your tax accountant.